Hello everybody. In this video we will see about mineral and power resources of class 8 geography. A naturally occurring substance which has a definite chemical composition is called as a mineral. And these minerals are not evenly distributed throughout the world. They are concentrated in some particular areas or in some particular rock formations. Some minerals are found in areas which are not easily accessible, like Arctic Ocean bed or Antarctic Ocean bed. You get the minerals. Minerals are formed in different geological environments under varying conditions. They are created by natural process without any human intervention. They can be identified on the basis of the physical properties like color, density, hardness, and chemical properties like whether they are soluble. There are over 3000 different types of minerals. On the basis of composition, minerals are broadly classified as metallic and non-metallic minerals. The metallic minerals contain metal in raw form. Metals are hard substances that are good conductors of heat and electricity and have a characteristic luster or shine. Iron ore, bauxite, manganese are some of the examples of metallic minerals. These metallic minerals can be further subdivided into two as ferrous or non-ferrous minerals. Ferrous minerals like iron ore, manganese and chromites, which contain iron in it, are called as ferrous minerals. Non-ferrous minerals does not contain iron but may contain some other metal such as gold, silver, copper or lead. Do you know a rock is an aggregate of one or more minerals but without definite composition of constituent of minerals? Rocks from which minerals are mined are known as ores. Although more than 3000 types of minerals have been identified, only about 100 are considered as ore. Thus, one can easily notice that all minerals are rocks, but all rocks are not minerals. The second type of mineral is non-metallic minerals. They do not contain metals. Limestone, mica and gypsum are examples of such minerals. They are mostly the type of rocks. The mineral fuels like coal, petroleum are also considered to be a non-metallic mineral but are also called as energy minerals. Minerals can be extracted by mining, drilling and quarrying. So we call it as extraction. We take it out from the earth's surface or from on the surface or under the surface. We extract the minerals. So there are three different types of extracting the minerals: mining, drilling and quarry. The process of taking out minerals from rocks buried under the earth's surface is called mining. Minerals that lie at shallow depths are taken out by removing the surface layer. This is known as open cast mining. In the open cast mining, wherever you are, you can see the sky. So it's like on the surface, your whatever the minerals are available, you are taking out from that surface area. A good example is Neyveli, where we are mining lignite. It is having an open cast mining. Second one is shaft mining, where deep bores, which are also called as shafts, have to be made to reach mineral deposits that lie at the great depths is called as shaft mining. Tunnel mining, all of you know, the image which comes is a tunnel mining, that is called as shaft mining. The next one is drilling. Petroleum and natural gas occur far below the earth's surface. So deep wells are bored to take them out. This is called drilling. Minerals that lie near to the surface are simply dug out by the process known as quarrying. Here you can see the pictures of different types of extraction of minerals. Open cast mining and then shaft mining, mining and quarrying, and then shaft tunnel mining, how it is done, and also the drilling of oil off the shore, that is in the Arabian Sea. Also we are extracting drilling the oil. So with this we come to the conclusion of this video. Hope you understood. Thank you.